Welcome back to the studio. I'm Shauna Henderson, joined by Aaron with Red Buffalo Cafe. And Aaron, one of my favorite coffee shops. Tell the viewers a little bit about Red Buffalo.
Absolutely. So Red Buffalo, we're a specialty coffee shop in Silverthorne, Colorado. And we really try to adhere to our three pillars that make us who we are. And that is our community involvement, our commitment to excellence in specialty coffee, and our environmental stewardship programs. I think those three things are gonna make a wonderful business to come into. You're gonna have a good community feel, you're gonna know we're gonna be doing good things for the community. We're following great guidelines on brewing and extracting coffee from the Specialty Coffee Association, that our baristas are trained by the Baristas Guild of America, and that we're doing great things to limit our carbon footprint and our environmental footprint.
And that is huge. You know, the local community environment really makes a huge difference. And you guys also have just recently won an award, is that correct?
We did. We're really proud of it.
Congratulations,
by the way. The Chamber of Commerce had our Business Excellence Awards this past month, and we were awarded for the Environmental Champion Award.
Wow.
Which means a lot to us because, you know, I think there's a statistic out there that there's enough coffee cups that are thrown away every year to circle the globe twice.
Wow.
And since we started our zero waste program, because this whole cup and lid, et cetera, is all compostable, we've diverted over 750,000 cups and lids from the landfill.
That is huge.
In addition to other stuff. But that's just one fact that we're just really proud of. I think it's something that, as a small business, you have a responsibility to the community that you're in.
And to make sure you're stewards of the earth, because we're,
yes,
you know, that is huge.
Well, coffee comes from the earth. If we want to have coffee around, we have to treat the earth that it's growing in well.
Right, and that makes a huge difference. And so what have we brought here today when our Earth Choice, Making a Difference, just as a reminder?
Yes.
Yeah.
I brought you one of our chais. We use Third Street as our chai company. They're down in Boulder. Mm-hmm. They are also 100% wind offset. Mm. And we have an 80 by 80 rule at Red Buffalo, where 80% of our products come from companies within an 80-mile radius. So we really try to keep it Colorado local, Summit County local when we can, because, you know, coffee is international. but the companies that we work with should be as much Colorado as we can.
Yeah, that's great. And it has a nice sweet taste to it. So tell us how you've made this chai, because a lot of people might be intimidated by chai, like, ooh, how do I actually prepare it?
This, you know, is, there's lots of different really types of chai. So we carry two. This is Third Street. This is kind of what most people in the U.S. are going to be a little bit more familiar with. Mm. It's a sweetened chai. It's not really sweet, but it's sweetened and it's a little on the spicy side. We also have our house brew chai that we brew in-house, and that one's unsweetened, and it's going to be more traditional of what you might find kind of in Asia. It's going to be, like I said, that unsweetened, brewed in-house. But you can do so many different things with it. Actually, with the chai, I like to use that as the base in our oatmeal.
Oh, wow.
We have a couple of good healthy breakfast items. We have our avocado toast, which is delicious. We have a build-your-own smoothie menu, and I like to do the spinach matcha smoothie. But having chai in the oatmeal just has this kind of fun, spicy kick to it.
And you would never think that, and it really has this very unique flavor, and I just, you know, love chai, and we forget about it sometimes. What a great alternative.
I think people are like, well, if I don't drink coffee, I should drink tea, but they kind of skip over chai in the middle and go towards the tea. And we carry only loose leaf tea at Red Buffalo, which
huge,
makes such a difference.
Yes. Why does that make such a difference? You know,
I like to equate it to, you know, Keystone Light versus a microbrew.
Okay.
You know, you have tea bag versus loose leaf tea, but it's going to breathe a lot more. It's going to have a lot more body and a lot more flavor to it. What's in a tea bag is really like the dusting that falls off of loose leaf tea after it's been processed.
Interesting.
And even if you put loose leaf in a bag, it doesn't breathe like a wine. You know how you want to kind of decant a really good wine?
Right, because you bring out those flavors.
Exactly. Correct? And that's what you do with loose leaf when you brew it in an infusing basket, is you really give it a chance to get all of its flavors out. Our jasmine tea, just this straight jasmine, is so floral and rich, and it doesn't taste slightly astringent like you're gonna get in some of the teabag jasmines.
Yeah, that's really interesting. You guys are doing some really, really fun things on the weekend as well, is that correct?
Yeah, we have live music on Saturdays, which is super fun. You know, this weekend is Valentine's Day weekend, even though it's not Valentine's Day on the weekend, it's still a good place to come, and coffee makes a great non-committal date.
Right.
It's really easy to navigate. There's quick outs and easy ins. You can progress from there. And then the
so that's a great date spot, right?
It is. I've seen several first dates. Uh-huh. I've seen a couple breakups. Those are really awkward. But I've seen many first dates, and sometimes those are awkward too. But they're really just fun to see. And it's a good place and an atmosphere to come and hang out and just get a good vibe of what's going on.
Yeah, especially right by the river you guys are located. Yes. So where are you guys located? How do people find more information?
Well, we're 358 Blue River Parkway in Silverthorne, so that's just a quarter mile north of the I-70 Silverthorne Interstate exit, so close to everything you want to do in Silverthorne. We're right next to the Pavilion, the outlets, the rec center. If you do happen to be having to go onto I-70, come on into Red Buffalo before you go wait on that road. So just everything you want that's right in Silverthorne.
Oh, that's wonderful. Well, thank you, Erin, so much
for joining me.
I always learn something new. This is an absolutely amazing chai. Thank you for bringing this with me.
Of course, my pleasure.
And we'll see you again next Monday. Yeah. Thank you, guys, and we'll be back after this break.